What's up internet, my name is Manish and you can find me on rebellionrider.com where we make learning SQL and Oracle database fun. And today in this SQL tutorial we will learn what is a view with respect to Oracle database. Yes, this tutorial is all about view in Oracle database. So without wasting further time, let's start the tutorial. A view is nothing but a logical table stored in a database. We can also define a view as a select statement with a name which is stored in a database as though it were a table. All the DML commands which you can perform on a table can also be performed on a view also. Of course, there are some restrictions which we will discuss in this tutorial. You can visit my blog on the same topic for more in-depth knowledge. So let's create some view, but before that let's take a look at the syntax. This is a syntax of very simple view which starts with create and view keyword followed by the name of the view. You can assign any name of your desire to your view. Next we have as, which is again an Oracle reserved keyword. Followed by as keyword we have our select statement, which is self-explanatory I suppose. But if you still have some confusion regarding this select statement, you can watch my tutorial 5. There I have explained the concept of data retrieval using select DML in detail. Link is in the description box. So now that you are familiar with the syntax of the view in Oracle database, therefore let's move ahead and do some example. But for that we have to jump over our SQL developer, and here we are. Now I will connect to my database using my HR user. Let me quickly show you the user. As you can see right now I'm connected to my HR user, and now I will create a view by the name of VW_rebellion using my employees table. This is a very simple view created on employees table and has all the tuples from first name, email and phone number column from the base table employees. Let's execute. View created. Now let's try all the DML one by one on this view. You can see the definition of this view using describe command, similar to the way we do with the tables in Oracle database. And here is the definition of our view, VW Rebellion. I know describe is a DDL statement, not DML, but I thought this tip is worth sharing. So let's start with first DML command, which is select. But before that, I will close this script output. Now let's write the query. Let's execute. And as you can see here, we have all the tuples from first name, email and phone number column. You can also use where as well as order by clause in your select query if you want. Let me show you how. As you can see, the result of this query is sorted lexicographically using first name column. Similarly, you can use where clause. And here is the record of the employee named Nancy. Okay, next you can also execute update DML command. Suppose you want to update the email address of employee Nancy, then query for this will be. But first, let me close this query result. Okay, now let's write the query. Let's execute. One row updated. Let's check. And here is the result. See how easy it is? Similarly, you can also execute delete DML command to delete one or more rows from the table using views. Let me show you how. But first, let me once again close all these output windows. Okay. One row deleted. Remember, whatever DML you are executing on your view will directly affect the underlying table, which means deleting and updating rows in view will delete or update the rows in the base table. Okay, let's move ahead. Next, let's try the last DML command on views in Oracle database, which is insert. Okay, let's do the query. Let's execute this insert query. Wait, what happened? An error? Yes, an error. This is because every view has to satisfy all the constraints on any column of underlying table over which it's created. And insert DML is subject to several restrictions when executed on a view in Oracle database, such as a view must contain all the not null columns from underlying table. And if there is any column with referential key constraint in underlying table, then view must contain that column and a proper value must be provided to that column while performing insert on the view, and many more. Thus, to perform an insert DML on our view VW Rebellion, we have to include all the columns which either have not null constraint or referential constraint or any other mandatory constraint from the base table employees. So let's move on to our next example. For this example, I have created a very simple table by the name of superheroes. Let me show you. But first, let me make some space so that you people can see things clearly. Now let me show you my superheroes table. As you can see, this table has 5 columns: first name, last name, real name, phone number, and SSN, which stands for Social Security Number. Now, I will create a view on this table. Suppose there is a user who wants data from this table, but as an owner of this table, you do not want to reveal the confidential data such as the real name or Social Security Number of all the superheroes to that user. In this case, you can take advantage of view in Oracle database and mark the column which you do not want to show. Let me show you how. Let's execute and create this view. View is created. Let's quickly fire a select query and see what data this view has. Here we have all the first name and last name along with the telephone number. No real name of all these superheroes, which means their identity is still hidden from this world. Except the identity of Tony Stark, he's an arrogant billionaire who revealed his secret in front of the world himself. But that doesn't matter, we all love Iron Man. Now you can share this view with that user who wants to use data from this table as your confidential data is safe and sound. Moreover, you can execute insert DML on this view as the underlying table does not have any constant to satisfy. Let me show you how. Let's execute. This time, row inserted successfully. Next, I will show you how to change the definition of a view in Oracle database. In the view VW superheroes which we just created, you displayed the first name and last name of the superheroes along with the phone number. And now you realize that you do not want anyone to see their phone numbers also. And you want to change the view definition. So let's see how you can do it. To change the definition of a view, we use replace keyword along with the create keyword at the starting of the command. I'll show you how. Apart from the replace keyword, everything in this command is very similar to that of the last create view command which we executed earlier. Execution of this command will replace the definition of the old VW underscore superheroes view with the definition of new VW underscore superheroes view. Let's execute. View created. Let's quickly check the definition of new VW underscore superheroes view. As you can see, no phone number column this time. Hope the concept of views in Oracle database is clear to you now. Please visit my blog on the same topic. There you can also learn how to create a view by joining tables. Link is in the description box. With this, I will wind up today's tutorial. Please hit the thumbs up button if you like this video and subscribe to my channel. Also, help me in reaching out to more people by sharing this tutorial on your Facebook, Twitter, or any other social media. Thanks for watching. We'll see you soon with another SQL tutorial. Till then, take care. This is Manish from Rebellion Rider.